So, how has Olympic legacy evolved over the last century? And how has the IOC played its part in embedding into the consciousness of a host city, and indeed a host nation, that ambition for long-term benefits? We start the story here in Stockholm's Olympiastadion, host venue for the 1912 Olympic Games.
You can feel the distant echoes of sporting glory in the corridors and passageways of this much-loved stadium. It may be one of the smallest in the history of the Olympic Games, but it's produced more world records than many other track and field arenas.
Unlike so many historic sports arenas, this place has remained largely untouched by the years, and we have the city of Stockholm to thank for that. And 100 years on, this place is a powerful testimony that the Olympic spirit still burns brightly here.
The football team, Djurgården, they were thinking of taking the track away. It's like taking the heart out of the stadium. I think the Olympic Stadium keeps the sport together, and to participate in Stockholm for every athlete, it's something special.
Is there also a sense of the younger generation feeling pride? They've got this sense of history and that Stockholm is an Olympic city.
Yeah, and they feel it when they come here. As soon as you enter here, you feel a little bit of the history. Our main goal is to make young people more physically active. So that's going to be our legacy from this Jubilee.
It's really nice to be training in the stadium which has such a cultural history. The Olympics will always be a part of my heart.
Even when a city isn't successful in its bid to host the Games, its Olympic ambition can still inspire change.
Hammarby Sjöstad was intended to form part of Stockholm's bid for the 2004 Summer Olympic Games. The city lost out to Athens, yet the bid was a real impetus to continue with the development and use it as a pilot for environmentally friendly housing. The area has been transformed from a polluted ex-industrial site into a popular neighbourhood for young families.
We wanted to build the first environmental Olympic village in the world. So with very much environmental thinking, material choices, waste sorting, transportation, etc. That is how Hammarby Sjöstad was built. The environmental agenda was quite high at the time, just some few years after the Rio conference. And this was the opportunity to actually make this happen.